Hello everyone. Today in this video we are going to discuss last subtopic of this second unit, that is termination of banker customer relationship. In previous videos we have seen how this relationship comes into existence. Now at the end of the second unit we are going to talk about the termination, means the end, how this relationship between banker and customer will come to an end. We have seen that this banker-customer relationship comes into existence by way of an agreement between banker and customer. It is a contractual relationship. Both the parties will have rights and duties towards each other. Now, by termination, coming to an end of this relationship, both the parties will not have rights and obligations towards each other. So, in this subtopic, we are going to talk about the ways or how or the reasons for termination of banker-customer relationship. That is also known as closure of account. So, in simple terms, when the customer closes the account, when the account is closed, the banker-customer relationship comes to an end. It will be termination of banker-customer relationship. The relationship between banker and customer comes into existence with opening a bank account. So when a customer opens a bank account, this relationship comes into existence. It is a contractual relationship. Now this relationship will be terminated, will come to an end by closing the account. So relationship comes into existence by opening account, closing account, end of that relationship. So closure of customer's account means the relationship between banker and customer comes to an end. Closing of bank account means termination of relationship between the banker and his customer. When account is closed, so when the account of the customer is closed, the credit balance which is available in the account of the customer should be paid to the customer. Now, what are the ways in which account can be closed? Account can be closed in three ways. It can be closed, it can be the customer's own act, customer himself wants to close that account, or at the request of the banker, banker wants to close that account, or as per the operation of law, due to some procedure of the law, the account is to be closed. Now, we are going to talk about reasons or circumstances for closing the account. First reason, mutual agreements. Notice by the customer in writing, notice by the banker, notice of death of customer, notice of customer's insanity, notice of insolvency of the customer, notice of assignment, and garnishee order. So these are the 8 reasons for closing the account of the customer. So few are from customer's side, customer wants to close the account, few are from banker's side, banker wants to close account, and few are due to the operation of law, that is garnishee order, notice of assignment. These are due to the operation of law. Now one by one we are going to discuss all these points in detail. The first point is mutual agreements. So sometimes this mutual agreements, it is asked for 2 marks in section A. What do you mean by mutual agreements? So when both the parties mutually agree, the banker can close the customer's account. Both the parties want to close the account, banker can close the account. When the account is closed, it is the termination of relationship between banker and customer. So when both parties want that this banker-customer relationship should come to an end, at that time the banker can close the customer's account. Second point, notice by the customer in writing. So if the customer desires, he can close his account with the bank at any time, whenever customer wants. So when the customer wants, he opens an account. When he doesn't want to keep that account, maintain that account, he can close that account. So when the customer withdraws the entire balance from the account, automatically the account can be closed. It is, as per the law, it is not binding on the customer, or it is not compulsory for the customer to give a notice of his intention of closing the account to the banker, but at least the customer has to inform the bank. It is expected that the customer should inform. So when the customer wants to close the account, he can withdraw the entire balance. Entire balance, when it is withdrawn, it is implied that the account is can be closed. So customer legally he is not bound to give the notice of his intention of closing the account, but at least he has to inform the banker about his intention of closing the account. Now, what may be the reasons for which the customer may would like to close the bank account? So the first reason may be customer is not satisfied with banker's services, or customer is not satisfied the terms or rules or terms and conditions or rules put forth by the bank, or the customer loses confidence in his banker, or the customer feels that the account is not necessary for him. So these are the reasons for which the account is to be closed, or this relationship comes to an end from customer's side. Account can be closed. Generally, the notice is given in writing to the banker by the customer for closing his account in the bank. After receiving the notice from the customer, the banker closes the customer's account. Now, third point, notice by the banker. So, second point, we have seen that when customer wants to close the account. Now, the third point, when the banker wants to close particular customer's account. Now, the banker has a right to close the account of a particular customer. When the banker has a right to close the account of a particular customer, when banker finds that that particular person or that particular customer is an undesirable customer, banker doesn't want to serve that person, give services as a banker to that person. In that case, the banker can close the account of the customer, but before closing the account of the customer, banker has to give notice to the customer about banker's intention of closing that customer's account. So what may be the reasons for which the banker would like to close the customer's account, or banker is not interested in serving such a customer? So he is an undesirable customer. When the customer will be undesirable customer, when he has a habit of drawing a check for entire balance, he withdraws the entire balance by way of a check, or frequently issues a check without providing funds. There is no balance which is maintained in the account, and without maintaining the balance, he gives a check. Balance maintained in the account is less than the minimum, or account is not operated for a long time, or the customer is convicted for forgery of checks or bills. In such situations, the banker can close the customer's account by giving a notice to the customer. So notice has to be given by the banker. 1 month advance notice has to be given, and the reasons have to be mentioned in that notice. And this notice has to be given in writing by registered post. Immediately, the banker cannot close the customer's account. If the banker will close the account immediately without giving a notice or without sufficient reason, it will lead to the customer in awkward position. To avoid that, legally, banker has to give notice of its intention to close the customer's account. 1 month advance notice has to be given. Fourth point, notice of death of customer. When the banker receives the notice of customer's death, banker should suspend the operations of the deceased customer's account. Immediately, no checks will be honored by the banker. Immediately stop the operations of that account of the customer, deceased customer. Checks presented after receiving notice of death should be returned with remark, drawer deceased. So, what checks the banker receives after the death of the customer, after the notice of the death of the customer, he should not honor those checks. The banker has to return those checks. On those checks, banker has to write drawer deceased, and banker should not honor such checks. So this is a point on which sometimes a case study will be asked. The banker receives a check from the account of a particular customer, but he receives a notice of the death of the customer. What the banker should do? So banker should not honor such a check, and he should return that check with a remark, drawer deceased. before suspending the deceased customer's account, banker should ascertain the news from reliable sources. Banker should never depend upon the rumors. So, usually, banker, after receiving the notice of death, closes the customer's account and the balance will be paid to the legal representative of the deceased. So, as soon as the banker receives the notice of death of the customer, immediately stop the operations of that account, suspend that account. No checks will be paid from that account. Check should be returned with a remark, drawer deceased. Ascertain the news from reliable sources. Don't depend upon the rumors. Then the banker, after receiving the notice of death, close the customer's account and balance paid to the legal representatives of the deceased on giving up an evidence or proof of that they are the legal heirs of the deceased. Then that balance has to be given to them. Fifth point, notice of customer's insanity. So when the customers become insane, in that case, the banker must close the account of his customer on receiving a notice of insanity of the customer. So in here also the banker should not depend upon the rumors, but banker should have the sufficient evidence of that customer being admitted to the mental hospital. He has taken the treatment for his disease or for insanity. Such proof the banker should get, evidence the banker should get, then only the banker should close the customer's account. So, because the insane person is considered as an incompetent person as per the Contract Act, therefore, this banker-customer relationship, it is a contract between these two parties. Therefore, the banker immediately should close the customer's account on receiving the notice of insanity of the customer. So, it is considered that insane is a person, he is incompetent person, he is unable to know the consequences of his act. For that purpose, his account has to be immediately closed. Before closing the customer's account, banker must get evidence. Usually, banker asks for certificate from registered medical practitioner. So, after receiving the doctor's certificate, the banker can close the customer's account. Now, after closing the account, the balance of the insane person will be paid as per the law or as per the court order. So, if any legal representatives will be there or if any court order is issued, as per that, the balance has to be paid by the banker to a particular person. Next point, notice of insolvency of customer. Insolvent is a person who is declared as insolvent by a court of competent jurisdiction. A person who is unable to pay his debts and dues, that person is called as an insolvent person. Now, when the customer becomes insolvent, the relationship between the banker and the customer comes to an end. Banker closes the customer's account after receiving the notice of insolvency of the customer. So, as per Indian Contract Act, insolvent person is incompetent to contract. Therefore, immediately when he is declared as insolvent by the court, that relationship comes into end. That relationship will be ended, comes to an end. Now, banker stops the payment from customer's account. The account will be freezed. The banker has to transfer the balance of insolvent customer's account to official liquidator or official receiver. So, when the person is to be declared as insolvent by the court of competent jurisdiction, court appoints one person as official receiver or official liquidator, and all the property belonging to person, whether bank balance or everything, will be cast in the account of the official receiver. So, such a customer's account will be closed. Now, seventh point, notice of assignment. Sometimes the customer transfers his entire balance to another bank or another person. That means it is an implication that the customer wants to close the account with the banker. This type of transfer is known as assignment. The customer transfers his entire balance to another bank or another person, it is an implication to the banker to close the account. This is known as transfer as by assignment. After receiving the notice of assignment, banker should transfer the amount or pay it to the assignee. Assignee is the person to whom the amount is assigned, whole balance. After assigning the whole amount from the particular customer's account, banker, it is an implication to the banker to close the account of that customer. And eighth point is garnishee order. Garnishee order, as we have already discussed about garnishee order, that is, garnishee order is an order issued by a court to the bank. So when the banker receives the garnishee order, the banker should immediately stop the operation of customer's account. Balance which is there in the customer's account should be paid to the judgment creditor, that the person who has filed a case against the debtor, that means customer. The account should, the balance from the account should be given to the judgment creditor as per the orders of the court. This has to be done by the banker immediately after receiving the notice of from the court, that is garnishee order. So here today we have completed the second unit of banking law practice. From next video we are going to start third unit. Thank you very much.